Hi, Ben. This is Mike from ZSA. I just wanted to jump in here and offer up some tips for assigning keys quickly in Oryx. Now, if you're reassigning your whole layout and you're setting up a bunch of complex keys, some of that can take a little bit of time to reassign and get set up the way you'd like. But here are a few techniques that can hopefully help with assigning things a little faster in Oryx. So the first thing is going to just be assigning by tap. And to do that, I'm going to move over to my symbols and numbers layer here. And let's say I want to change these function keys to just be the regular number keys. A quick way to do this would be just clicking on the key and then typing the key I'd like to assign it to. So 1, 2, 3, and etc. By tapping the key on my keyboard, this works really well for quickly assigning simple keys. That can get a little more tricky if you need to set up multifunction keys or if you need to set up a specific symbol. It doesn't work quite as well for that. But for assigning simple keys quickly, assigning by tap is really nice. Next thing is going to be searching for keys. So let's say I want to change this exclamation mark to a tilde symbol, which is not something I have easy access to from my main layer on my keyboard. So if I go ahead and I click on this and I click on tapped, rather than clicking change and scrolling through and looking for the tilde key, what I can do is right from this screen, I can just search for tilde and then click it right there just to speed things up a little bit. You can also swap keys around. So let's say that on my main layer, I use escape more than I use caps word. And so I want to change the positions of these two keys. For this, I can click swap keys, click on the first key I want to swap, and then the second one, and it'll swap them around. So now caps word's up there and escape is down here. For the last couple things I want to show you, I'm going to go ahead and create a new layer. And the first thing is when I click on this, we actually have either new layer or browse templates. And if I click on browse templates, I can scroll through here. You can also submit a layer to be featured here. There's a couple things for Voyager, the default layer, a blank layer, some Colmac or Colmac DH examples, stuff like that. But let's say I want to make my own new layer. If I go in here and I click on new layer, I have a whole blank layer here. And one of the things that I find myself frequently doing is when I make a new layer, maybe I want to assign like a number pad on this side or something like that, but I don't want the rest of these keys to still be active or transparent from my base layer. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to assign one key with the none function. That just means that when pressed, this doesn't do anything. Now, thankfully, I don't have to type that for every single one of these keys. What I can do is I can click on the key, and this works for pretty much any key in Oryx. And I'm going to go ahead and just click this little copy to other keys button. And after I've done that, then I can click everywhere where I'd like that none key to be assigned. So I can just block out, for example, this whole left half. Let's say this layer is just going to be on the right half. And there you go. That was nice and fast, and that works for pretty much any key you'd like it to be. All right, I hope that helps a little bit with your layouting in Oryx. Cheers.